almost a decade, the seafront has been spoilt by Britain's second ugliest building, the IMAX. This was determined in a recent poll. For over 3 years, the IMAX has been in disuse and a cause of constant debate between townspeople, yet nothing has been done. Follow me, let's go see what else the seafront has to offer. The pier, the pride of Bournemouth, charges 50p a time just to walk along to the end of it, at the end of which you'll find very few attractions.
You coming?
The oceanarium holds exotic sea life from all over the world. Very exciting on your first visit, but doesn't really merit a second, especially at £8.50 per person. Let's go see where the young people hang out. Despite the attractions there are in Bournemouth, a lot of young people tend to come up here. This is what they call the double deckers. It's further up on the beach, a little bit more out the way.
Good time.
Yeah. So guys, do you come here very often?
Yeah, a lot.
Yeah, occasionally.
What do you think could be changed or done to make it easier or make it better places to go in Bournemouth rather than coming here and getting drunk?
If there were cheaper attractions or, you know, somewhere for people like the Irish to go, really,
Do you think a lot of trouble gets caused here, you know, with you lot all drinking and stuff?
Yeah.
Obviously, yeah, I mean, people when they drink, you know, do stupid stuff when they're sober. And just generally, people look down upon people our age drinking, really.
Thank you very much.
No worries.
Thank you.
Hi, Mom.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Tash.
Hello.
Hello.
Would you like to introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm Chris Borland. I'm a police community support officer for Dorset Police.
Do you get many young people around this area?
Yes, we do.
What kind of, do you think they cause very much trouble?
On the whole, I think they're very well behaved. I do think there are the odd person who does spoil it for the rest, and I think there are a few issues that do need to be dealt with.
What do you think could be done or changed to maybe prevent or improve the issues and problems that go on along here?
Bournemouth has just invested in more cameras for the town and for the seafront here. I think that's going to help us dramatically this year. Also, there's two PCSOs for the area who will just purely cover the beachfront, so that'll help with the issues here. I do think what could be improved is that there's more services for young people to perhaps divert them from committing antisocial behaviour on the streets and keep them occupied.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure, thanks.
Now we're going to go get someone else's opinion. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Would you like to introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm Ted Taylor, the local ward councillor for Kinston South. I'm also the champion of children and young people for the Bournemouth Council.
Cool. Many young people aren't happy with the facilities at the seafront. Do you think they have a point?
They do have a point, because there's very little down here for young people, and hopefully in the future they'll have a greater say in that particular issue.
How do you think we could change this?
Well, I believe you may be meeting John Beasley. We're looking at the Bournemouth Vision Plan, and they're looking at the possibility of what we can do over the next 12 months. Now is the opportunity for young people to say, this is what we want from young people in Bournemouth, and this is the service you should be providing for us that we can enjoy.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the interview.
Now we're going to go see if we can get hold of Councillor Beasley. Hello.
Hello.
Would you like to introduce yourself?
Certainly. I'm John Beasley. I'm Deputy Leader of Bournemouth Council, and one of my jobs is to look after the Town Centre Master Vision.
How are you going to make sure that you get young people's opinions in that?
Well, we want to go out and get a really wide consultation, because we want to make sure we talk to as many young local people as we can, because we want to be providing the sort of facilities that they want and that they'll use.
Cool. What do you think young people want over at the seafront?
Well, we've heard already some of the priorities. One of them is for an ice rink. Another is for some sort of wet facility. We've lost the swimming pool in the middle of Bournemouth. But there are a whole lot of other things that young people have been telling us they want. We want to hear the widest range of opportunities so that we can consider all of them.
Okay, thank you very much.
That's my pleasure. Nice to meet you.
Bye. It has become clear that not only young people, but local councillors and PCSOs feel the need for all year round activities and services for young people at the seafront. It looks like the council is ready to make some changes. If these plans go ahead, they could reduce underage drinking and antisocial behaviour, making the seafront more like home.